holding on to gains about 0.5%. 13,800 is where we're currently at. Real estate, of course, your big winner. Banks as well participating. Infrastructure, financials, FMCG, automobiles, cap goods, they're all contributing as sectors. But let's move on and let's welcome on board Chandar Agarwal from TCI Express to talk about how their business has been headed. Chandar, hi, morning. Good to have you on the show. It seems that one of the focal points of the upcoming package is to help bring down costs for logistics players by about almost 5%. At least that is the number which is being talked about. What are the various ways, according to you, that this can be achieved, you think?
I think the main factor that can actually make it happen is fuel prices. Now, I hope that if that is happening, then it's going to be very good for the economy in general, if they're going to lower the prices of fuel. The second would be, I think it's already announced by Mr. Gadkari that the toll plazas are going to go away in about 2 years' time. So that, I think, will start in phase-wise. They probably cannot do it right away. So I think that will be another aspect. And third would be definitely a reduction in GST on trucks is something that could happen. So if all these three major changes take place, overall, there could be an impact in logistics by almost 3%, 3.5%.
Sure. Entities from the Commerce as well as the Aviation Ministry, Chandar, have been meeting, and there is a talk of about, a huge air delivery thrust for the vaccine, which is when we last spoke with you. You said it was unlikely. But do you still think that the vaccine will have to be mass delivered by road only? Or, have you any indication on the same?
You know, the vaccine, what I understand, a lot of it initially would be imported, right? So they would be imported from Russia, if it's a Sputnik, or if it's AstraZeneca, then it's probably going to be imported from Europe. So that is where you would need the airport delivery part. But ultimately, for it to move to the village and taluka level, it cannot go by airports, by plane, for sure. So it would probably move in by truck, by containerized trucks. And also, my understanding is that there are no provisions for cold chain containers for the airplanes. None of the airplanes or none of the airlines that we know have that provision of having a cold chain inside the aircraft. So I don't think it's going to be possible for 1.5 billion people that the vaccination drive is going to be done through air cargo. It's probably in a smaller country or maybe in Europe, it's possible, but not in India for sure.
Sure. So within the logistics sector, this budget, apart from rising costs, what according to you would be the important issues, that would really help to propel the sector in terms of growth and profitability?
So number one is what I mentioned is fuel, like the fuel prices are going up. That is something which is going to drive down the profitability of most companies. I'm not saying for us, but for most other companies who are not able to manage their costs as effectively. So that anyway is, if you look at the logistics cost, it goes up to almost 60-70%. So 70%, if that cost is not controlled, then we do not see any sort of light at the end of the tunnel for reducing logistics cost. And another important thing is the the kind of assets that lie on the highways. They're quite dismal. The quality and the ability of those assets. What I mean by those assets are trucks. If they're not improved in terms of performance, if you're taking carrying a 14 ton load, and you're not able to speed up to 70 kilometers or 80 kilometers an hour, you're not going to be reducing the logistics cost in any way. If you go on the highway, you'll see that the average speed of trucks are still 45 to 48 kilometers. And how can we improve our, you know, production cycle matching with the consumption cycle if that is the case? So this is something which the government really needs to look into, you know, give these auto, like, truck manufacturing companies a hard time for improving their quality of assets that they manufacture.
What's the kind of opportunity as well? I mean, we touched upon the vaccine drive, but in terms of specific players that are capable of delivery here, you know, and the kind of distribution network possibly that we're looking at, you know, once the vaccine does arrive on domestic shores, what are the possibilities here, according to you?
So, you know, if you look at historically, vaccine distribution is quite, is well known to India. You know, we have had polio distribution, and, you know, we've had all sorts of, like, vaccinations for quite some time. I think even when there was, you know, large case of HIV, that we, there's no vaccination for that. But the kind of, like, mechanism that was, or the ecosystem that was created for the vaccination going to every village in Taluka was, is very strong. And I think using that as a leverage and as a, you know, point to kind of, like, bounce off would be easier for the government to distribute the vaccines. Now, how is that done and how was that done is very important to know. That wasn't done by air cargo. It was done by road. It was done by trucks doing a milk and run system. You know, milk and run worked very effectively when you have many villages in a state and many villages distributed widely across the district, is when the real benefit comes in. Now, even the storage, even if you have cold chain boxes, that is used for mainly for transportation of these vaccines. And that is done very cost effectively and very on time, in time basis. So anything which is not cost effective will not work in India. And what works in India is like road transportation. So we will see, I mean, whatever the naysayers say, have to say, or, you know, the fact is that it has to move by road. You know, if at all the government knew that it has to be distributed by air cargo or by air, they would be buying planes and helicopters and all of that. We haven't heard of that. So that is not happening.
Chandar, you know, just an extension of the point that you're talking about, you know, since we're talking about the vaccine here, and Gati, to my mind, is the only competitor who has capabilities such as yours. How is it that you think that when it comes to vaccine logistics in particular, you would fare as opposed to them?
Hard for me to say for a company that has been, you know, in the has not been with like weak management and all of that for some time. Hard for me to kind of like gauge as to their performance. But we have been doing cold chain business already for a while now. I think what I know is that their cold chain business is in heavy losses. I think they've had like 100 crore loss or something. So what you would essentially need for vaccine distribution is funds. You would need profitability. So, and we are quite cash rich, you know, and even as we go along, I do not see that even with our highlighted capex for the year, we would have substantial extra cash available for the vaccine distribution. And that is, I think, one of our strengths that is hard to kind of compete with.
Mm. Give us a sense, Chandar, as to what exactly it is that you're anticipating from the government rollout of the national logistics policy. We understand that this is going to be before the budget. What exactly would be on this wish list?
It's kind of like hard to say because they're not really disclosing much about it. As per my understanding, they could come up with some SOPs, possibly, increasing the truck demand, purchase of that. And, in general, they have been very obscure about what needs to be what they will be coming out with. They have never disclosed openly that, all right, they would be making, reducing the cess or, the GST on the fuel tax, on the fuel. None of that has happened. So the main basic, the big thing, they're not talking about. They're talking about, the toll plaza being free and all of that. Yes, that is a part of the cost, but not a substantial part of the cost.
Let you go on that note. Thanks very much, Chandar, for taking time out and giving us a sense as to what the outlook is when it comes to the logistics of the vaccine delivery, as well as what you're looking at in terms of key trends within the logistics sector.